In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God.
And the Word was with God.
And the Word was with God. And the Word was God.
The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him. And without Him was not anything made that was made.
In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not.
And so all Israel shall be saved, as it is written. There shall come out of Zion the Deliverer. They cry unto the Lord in their trouble, and He saveth them from their distresses. He sent His word and healed them, and delivered them from their destruction.
There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. For this is he that was spoken of the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness.
Prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. I indeed shall baptize you with water unto repentance. But he who cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He indeed shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire.
Oh,
There was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias, of the course of Abijah, and his wife Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blameless. And they had no child, because that Elizabeth was barren, and they were both well now stricken in years. And it came to pass that while he executed the priest's office before God in the order of his course, according to the custom of the priest's office, his lot was to burn incense when he went into the temple of the Lord. And the whole multitude of the people were praying without at the time of the incense. And there appeared unto him an angel of the Lord, standing on the right side of the altar of incense. And when Zacharias saw him, he was troubled, and fear fell upon him.
Fear not, Zacharias, for thy wife Elizabeth shall bear thee a son, and thou shalt call his name John. And thou shalt have joy and gladness, and many shall rejoice in his birth, for he shall be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall drink neither wine nor strong drink. and many of the children of Israel shall he turn to the Lord their God. And he shall go before him in the spirit and power of Elias to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord.
Whereby shall I know this? For I am old, and my wife well stricken in years.
I am Gabriel, that stand in the presence of God, and am sent to speak of and to show thee these glad tidings. And behold, thou shalt be dumb and unable to speak until the day that these things shall be performed, because thou believest not my words, which shall be fulfilled in their season.
And the people waited for Zacharias and marveled that he tarried so long in the temple. When he came out, he could not speak unto them. And they perceived that he had seen a vision in the temple. For he beckoned unto them and remained speechless.
And after those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived and hid herself 5 months.
Thus hath the Lord dealt with me, wherein the days he looked upon me, to take away my reproach among men.
Thank you.
Therefore the Lord shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary.
The angel Gabriel from heaven came, his wings as drifted snow, his eyes as tame. All hail, said he, the holy maid of Mary, most highly favored lady, Gloria. For dawn of blessed mother, thou shalt be all generations of an honor thee. Thy son shall be Emmanuel, my center of our souls, most highly favored lady, Gloria. A gentle Mary meekly bowed her head, to be as it pleaseth God, she said. My soul shall Lord and magnify your son,
Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
And when she heard these things, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be.
Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. And he shall be great, and called Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
How can this be, seeing that I know not a man?
The Holy Spirit shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born unto thee shall be called the Son of God. Behold also thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her which was called barren, for with God nothing shall be impossible.
I will travel many moonless nights, cold and weary, what I've done.
Behold, the handmaiden of the Lord, be it unto me according to his word.
And Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste, into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zacharias and saluted Elizabeth. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence is this to me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For lo, as soon as thy salutation was heard in mine ears, the babe leaped in my womb for joy. And blessed is she who believed, for there shall be a performance of those things which were told her of the Lord.
And Mary abode with her about 3 months, and returned to her own house. Now Elizabeth's full time came that she should be delivered, and she brought forth a son. And her neighbors and her cousins heard how the Lord had showed great mercy upon her, and they rejoiced with her. And it came to pass that they called him Zacharias, after the name of his father.
Not so, for his name shall be John.
And they made signs to his father, how he would have called. And he asked for a writing table, and wrote, "His name is John." they marveled all. And immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue loosed.
Oh, the God of Israel, ah, the God of Israel. Yes, the God of Israel, bless the God of Israel. Oh, the God of Israel. Ah, the God of Israel, yes, the God of Israel, like lightning in the night. Blessed and wonderful is the God of Israel. Strong and magnificent is the God of might, for he has brought his strength and he has come to fight, his mighty power to shower lightning in the night. Oh, the God of Israel, ah, the God of Israel. Yes, the God of Israel, bless the God of Israel. Oh, the God of Israel, ah, the God of Israel. Bless the God of Israel, like lightning in the night. Are recovered, his people are revived, his people have a second wind, his people have new life, his people have refreshment, his people are put right, his people have a second youth, our jubilee of Israel, ah, the God of Israel. Yes, the God of Israel, bless the God of Israel. Oh, the God of Israel, ah, the God of Israel, is lightning in the night. Of the heavens will warm the heart so cold and bring the babe the moonbeams, the sunrise, the glimmer of the stream. For the highest of the heavens is the sound of silence, the soft breeze for our sails, the harmony for our souls. And you, child,
and the child grew and waxed strong in spirit and was in the deserts till the day of his showing unto Israel.
Now the birth of Jesus was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly.
But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying,
Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. Behold, she shall conceive in her womb and bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. All this was done so that it might be fulfilled of the prophet by the Lord, saying, Behold, a virgin shall conceive in her womb and bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Emmanuel, God with us.
Love and scare should be.
Knew her not till she had brought forth his firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, each one to his own city.
And Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, unto the city of David called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary his wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were completed that she should deliver.
Flesh and he dwelt among us.
cometh into the world, he saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldst not, but a body thou hast prepared me. Then said he, lo, I come. In the volume of the book it is written of me to do thy will, O God.
And there were, in that same country, shepherds abiding their field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass, the shepherds said unto one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger.
When they had seen it, they made it known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things, and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had seen and heard, as it was told unto them.
Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, my Lord, everywhere I go, somebody talking about Jesus. They turned away Mary and Joseph from the inn. Somebody talking about Jesus, a baby born in Bethlehem. Somebody talking about Jesus. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, my Lord, everywhere I go, somebody talking about
somebody talking about Jesus. Born on a Christmas morn. Somebody talking about Jesus. Oh, everywhere I go, everywhere I go, my Lord, everywhere I go, somebody talking about Jesus. Talking about Jesus, oh, everywhere I go, everywhere I go, my Lord, everywhere I go, somebody talking about Jesus.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem.
Thank you. Where is he, born King of the Jews?
For we have seen a star in the east.
And are come to worship him.
When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for it is thus written by the prophet, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when it privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star had appeared, and he sent them to Bethlehem.
Go and search diligently for the young child, and bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also.
And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it came and stood where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Now they must follow
And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way.
And when 8 days were accomplished for the circumcising of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was so named of the angel before he was conceived. And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. The same was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Ghost was upon him. And it was revealed unto him by the Holy Ghost that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord Christ. And he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him after the custom of the law, then he took him up in his arms and blessed God.
Lord, now let thy servant depart in peace according to thy word, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and thy people Israel.
And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him, and Simeon blessed them.
Behold, this child is set for the fall and rising again of many people, and for a sign that shall be spoken against. Yea, a sword shall pierce thy own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed.
My love, my darling, you. tender, helpless, tiny brain with boundless gifts of grace.
Behold, the angel of the Lord appeareth to Joseph in a dream, saying,
Arise, and take the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him.
When he arose, he took the young child and his mother by night, and departed into Egypt.
For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world.
And as many as received him, to them he gave power to become sons of God, even to them that believe on his name.
And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father,
full of grace and truth.